Since soybeans are such an important crop, farmers need to figure out how to protect their crops from pests. So, what can they do to keep their plants healthy?
Integrated pest management, or IPM, is the concept of bringing together a lot of different disciplines, or a lot of different information to make the best and most responsible decision out in your field. And so farmers can get information from plant pathologists, from entomologists, weed scientists, agronomists, ag engineers, climatologists, and even economists, and they can bring a lot of this information in, know what's out in their field, and then make a decision that's going to best manage the pests that they have. There's two steps to IPM. The first one is gathering information. I like to actually gather most of my information before I even get to the field. And this is where I get on the computer, look at local crop reports, look at the weather, and really try to gauge what exactly I could be finding out in the field. What I have in my hands here are corn and soybean field guides produced by Iowa State University Extension. And these outline the common problems like the diseases or insects or disorders that you would find in a corn or soybean field. The second step is a little more difficult. This is where we actually walk into a field and we start doing what's called field scouting. This is where we go out, have a plan as you walk through the field, look at the crop, and then really gather information on what you see and what kind of pest problems are out there. When scouting a field, it's important to know what a healthy plant looks like, so then you can compare it to what a sick plant looks like. It's also important to consider the time of year. For example, if you're scouting very early in the season, you're gonna have a certain set of diseases or insects or disorders that can be problematic. Or if you're scouting later in the season, you can have a completely different set of common problems that could occur in the field. So let's talk about using IPM to manage soybean cyst nematode, which is one of the most devastating diseases of soybean in Iowa and really across the world. The point of management of soybean cyst nematode is to try to keep the population of the nematode as low as possible in a field, or to keep the nematode out of the field completely. And so the first step in doing that is to be out and scout the field. And this is gonna involve two different things, either taking soil samples, sending them to a lab and having somebody process it and look for the nematode in that soil sample, or to be going and carefully pulling some of the plants during the season and looking for the soybean cyst nematode cyst on the roots of those plants. Once a farmer knows that he has soybean cyst nematode in his field, and this is gonna be from the soil samples or going out and scouting the field, this is when he starts implementing the different management strategies. And these can include planting a soybean variety that's gonna be resistant to soybean cyst nematode, planting non-host crop plants such as corn, and then also planting seed that has seed treatment on it that is going to deter the nematodes from wanting to feed on the roots. Now, if you think about IPM, remember that we also think about economics and the environment. And so as you're deciding which management strategy to use, oftentimes you think about the cost, you think about how much of the nematode is in the field, and then how many management strategies you want to start implementing to help best manage this pest in a field.
Deciding which management strategies to use and the best time to use them is the key to keeping plants as healthy as possible.